Welcome to part two of my CNC router build. Today, I'm going to be installing the Y-axis using aluminum tubing, and I'll also be installing the gantry. Enjoy! So I started off by mounting 1-inch square tubing into my custom-made 3D printed 45-degree brackets. Alright, so now I'm 3D printing out some more of these ball bearings, and now we're going to connect the old gantry onto our new rail system. So as you can see on our EMT rail gantry, we're shorter. So I just cut out a piece of wood, and this should give us enough clearance to connect to our new bearing. So now I'm going to make it happen. So here's the order of which I installed the ball bearing bracket. So we have our plastic ball bearing bracket, two nuts, a ball bearing, a washer, another ball bearing, two nuts, then another ball bearing bracket, then a lock nut to ensure that these never become loose. Next, I started off by cutting down some 1x4, then I used the jigsaw to cut out a notch into the two pieces I cut down. This will be used for the new gantry. Then to ensure that the notch was completely flat, I ended up milling the wood down using my drill press milling machine. Alright, so now I 3D printed out this piece of plastic, and this pretty much resembles the faceplate of the motor, so I'm just going to trace it out, then we'll drill and mill our pieces of wood. So I started off by marking and drilling my pilot holes along the gantry. Then I went back with a larger drill bit to drill out larger holes for the desired bolt sizes. Alright, so now I have my two bearings made, so now I just need to mount them on the rail, then we will connect our gantry onto them. So We'll see how that comes out, and that'll be our next step. I used 3 screws to connect my gantry to these wooden extenders. And now I screw the new gantry into place. Alright, so our new Y-axis is in place with our new gantry. So we're going to use this aluminum score tubing. And this seems to work really nice. So now I'm just going to demonstrate how nice and smooth this is. So I'm not applying a lot of force at all. So that definitely ensures that our bearings work. The score tubing was a fantastic idea. That this new design is going to last a while. So now we're just going to start working on our X-axis, then we'll work on our Z-axis, so enjoy. Alright, this concludes part 2 of my CNC router build. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss the next video.